Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Kiario.
While we keep waiting for a moment to live for, so can't nobody ever tell me that I'm wrong. Cause I'ma ride out with you still, the night is young. We keep going, we go, we go, we go. We wake back up and do it all again. We know, said fuck the world, we ride until the end. When all is said and done, look what we've become. I just want you to know that I did it.
Today I'm back with another video. I just want to say, if you are new here, thank you for tuning into my channel. Don't forget to subscribe, please, and thank you. It really means a lot to me. If you're returning, please hit that like button. And hi, how y'all doing? Welcome back. I hope everyone is having a great day. Today is Sunday, so I wanted to film a life update video, just answering some questions and updating you guys on where I've been, what I've been up to, what I've been doing, and you know, just how I've been. So yes, that's what this video is going to be about. So let's get in the video. I have a few questions. So the first question is, do you still live in Georgia? Yes, I still live in Georgia. I did move up north a while back, but I'm back in Georgia. I've been living here ever since, but I am thinking about moving. Do you still have night terrors? I'm not sure. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm not sure, because whenever, like I told y'all, I don't know. I'm just gonna leave it at that. I might do a more in-depth video in the future, but I don't know if I still have night terrors. I hope I don't, because when I did, like, it was crazy. Are you happy? I am happy, you know, and I feel like I've been happy for a while. Like, I'm a Libra, so I'm naturally like a happy person. I'm naturally like extremely optimistic. I wake up, like, if I'm having a bad day, I just gotta go to sleep and wake up and I'll be happy again. Because I just always try to look at the positives in life, because it's like you don't own all the problems in life. And so I feel like, you know, God has blessed us so much. The most we could do is just try to be happy, you know. And so right now I am happy, you know. Yeah, I am happy. Are you single? I guess like yes and no. Plans for the future. My plans for the future is just to really like grow and develop myself as a woman. I'm 25 years old, which means in 5 years I'll be 30 years old. And so I just have a lot that I want to do, a lot that I want to see, a lot of places I want to go, you know. I want to make a lot of new friends, I want to try a lot of new things, I want to learn a lot. And honestly, my plans for the future is really just to grow and develop myself into the woman that I always dreamed of being. It says, are you back cool with your family? Yes, I am. I haven't really talked to some of them, but for the most part, I'm back cool with my mom, back cool with my sister. I started talking back to some of my friends. I'm back cool with my family. The last time I visited NOLA was in 2018, but I'm probably going to be going within the next few weeks, so I'm excited about that. What keeps you going? Honestly, what keeps me going is that, you know, it's God's love. You know what I'm saying? I feel like he supplies all of us with love, and he gives us everything we need, you know, like he's our source. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like when we can't fight for ourselves, he fights for us. And so honestly, it's God, you know, like he pulls it all together for us and gives us the strength to keep going. What do you miss about your old life? What do you miss? What do you miss? Honestly, I miss my old life. Like, I miss my friends. We would have friend nights. I miss, you know, having date nights and going on dates and just being able to cuddle with my man and just being in like a loving, caring relationship. I do miss that. You know, I get lonely sometimes. I miss being able to just get up and go whenever I wanted. I just miss my old life, you know, and everything that came with it. My relationship with my family, with my friends, and just even myself, you know, like I was just so like I don't know, like, I just miss my life. Like, I used to go out to the clubs, I used to go out to dinner dates and brunch, and, you know, I used to travel a lot, so I just miss my old life and everything that came with it. What is the biggest lesson you've learned in the last 5 years? The biggest lesson I learned is that, you know, this too shall pass, and that, you know, you have to be prepared in life for anything to happen. Like, literally, you wake up and every day something new could happen, like something crazy that you were not expecting, and you just have to learn how to adapt, roll with the punches, and just to keep going and know that this too shall pass. So don't let one negative situation, like, keep you down or make you sad or make you depressed and make you feel like, you know, you can't go on. You just gotta, like, know that, you know, it'll get better. It's just like rain, it comes and it goes, just like the seasons, you know. So you just gotta keep it moving, you know what I'm saying? It's always gonna be obstacles in your way, and life is literally just about getting over those obstacles and learning from them and applying them, you know, to lessons in the future, and just, you know, growing and becoming a better person overall. So the biggest lesson I've learned is that, you know, you gotta lead with love and everything else will fall into place. Leave with love and everything else will fall into place, and put God first and trust in him, and, you know, that's the recipe, period. Do you feel misunderstood? Yes, I do. I do feel misunderstood because, you know, I feel like I'm so different, and not in a way it's like, oh, I'm so different, but just like, and just like I don't know, like, I just feel like I'm very unique, and I feel like people misunderstand that and they take it the wrong way and they spin it sometimes how they want to spin it. And sometimes I feel like people don't really care to understand me, or they don't want to understand me because, you know, they like discourse and drama or whatever, chaos. But I do feel misunderstood because my intentions and my heart is pure all the time. And in the midst of all that, it gets jumbled up and rambled up into something that's completely not what I am. So, you know, I do feel misunderstood, but it's okay because I know God understands me and God knows my heart. Okay? What is something that you want to do? Something that I really, really want to do is go to Bali, go to the Maldives, or go to Tennessee, like a cabin in Tennessee that has like this cute view of like the mountains and a hot tub. Like, I just want to go on a date and I want to travel. That is something that I really, really want to do because that's really something that I'm really used to. Like, in relationships, I'm used to just going to like nice different restaurants and just enjoying a date with the person that I'm with. And then also, I'm really used to traveling. Like, traveling has been a big part of my life. My mom has taken us because she loves to travel. That's like her thing. So she's taken us like so many different places, and you know, I really like traveling. Like, it's so fun. And so I haven't been able to do any of those things in quite a while, so that would be something that I would really enjoy. It says, moving forward, what is something that you plan to do? Moving forward, I plan to really, like, kind of try to make new friends and kind of try to, you know, form like daily habits so that I could be more disciplined, I guess, to get more things done and be more productive. You know, I plan on just trying to be more of like an adultier adult and everything that comes with that, you know, like managing my time better, eating healthy, exercising, learning as much as I possibly can, reading more books, and just, I plan on filling myself up with as much knowledge and working hard and enjoying my life. You know what I'm saying? The past, this year and then last year has shown us that, you know, life is precious. And so it's like, you know, do as much as you can, have as much fun as you can, help people as much as you can, and just, you know, really, 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 really give your all in everything that you're doing. And really just, I just want to, like, live. I just want to live my life to the fullest. You know, that's what I plan on doing. It says, do you still live in a hotel? Yes, I do still live in a hotel. It's kind of like an extended stay. So it has, like, most things that, like, a regular apartment would have. Like, it has, like, cable and, like, a dresser. It has, like, a nice comfy bed. It has, like, central air and heat, dining room table, microwave, refrigerator. It has, like, a, it has the stove top so you can cook. It has like cabinets and stuff, lots of cabinet space. And it has well, I went and got this like little oven thing from Walmart for like $20. So if I want to bake, I can bake. Like, I literally cooked the whole Thanksgiving dinner in there. Like, you can bake cookies, you can bake like flatbread pizza, you can bake like cake, bake macaroni, you can bake everything up in there. And it's like a oven, like just a mini oven. I have a mini oven, I have an air fryer, and so yeah. it says, are you currently reading any books? Yes, I'm reading this book that I got from, sorry y'all, that's the automatic air freshener thing. But yeah, I'm reading this book that I got from my mother. Sorry, I just had a brain freeze. I'm reading this book that I got from my mom. It's called The Art of Not Giving a F. And that's what I'm reading right now. And it's really good. My mom has had this book for years, but I never thought to just pick it up and read it. But it's a New York Times bestseller. It sold like over 2 million copies. So I'm reading it, and I'll let you guys know what I thought about it when I finish reading it. So it says, are you still being stalked? Am I still being stalked? Yeah. It says, what do you wish people knew about you? I wish people knew how much that like I am a good person, and how much like I don't care to see people like angry, upset, bitter, and in bad situations. Like, some people, they feed off like negativity that you know that's going on in other people's lives, and I want people to know how much that is not me. Like, I love seeing people win. I love seeing people be happy. I love seeing people thrive and reach their goals. And I love seeing people just like in their element, you know, and being in their purpose and doing what God has called them to do and just being happy. Like, I love seeing people like that. And so I just wish that people wouldn't think the worst of me based off rumors and he say she say. Like, I just want people to know that like I really am like a good person, and I have done a lot of self-work. So it's like I don't even have a reason to be like jealous, bitter, or hater, or like any of those things. Like, all that stuff is like psychological, and it's like how you treat someone is how you feel about yourself. What you say about someone is really how you feel about yourself. And I am like, you know, I've done a lot of like work, shadow work, to know those things. So it's like, it's kind of like a slap in the face, and it's kind of like it's like a slap in the face, like, girl, like, boo, sir, whatever. Like, I don't have no problem with none of y'all, and I want all y'all to be happy. So please, like, okay, like, leave me alone. What do you think your purpose is? Honestly, I think my purpose in this lifetime, honestly, I think it's just to really help people in every way that I possibly can, and just to be of service of others, and to show people, you know, that love is real, and love is the answer, and love conquers any type of hate, and that you can go through anything and still come out just as, you know, like if you are a diamond and you go through some BS in life, you can go through it and you can still come out a diamond. Like, you don't have to let life, you know, turn you into, you know, this bad person, or just this image of yourself that you don't even recognize because of all the things that you went through. So I think my purpose in life is just to show people that, like, no one determines who you are. Only you do. You know what I'm saying? And also, I think my purpose is literally to help people, to love people, to uplift people, and to just show them that love is the way, love is the answer, and yeah, to make people happy. And to get on people's nerves just a little bit. Cause I think I am just a little bit annoying, y'all. But I think we all kind of are. But yeah, my purpose is to uplift, motivate, make people happy. Period. It says something that you really, really want, guys. I really, 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 really want like a nice home with a pool in the backyard and a husband. Okay? Yes. What do you look for in a man? Okay, so I'm gonna name 5 things, or maybe 10. Okay, so I look for someone who is nice, someone who is, excuse me, someone who is, I'm gonna do five. Someone who is nice, someone who is kind, someone who is loyal, someone who is ambitious, and someone who loves God, someone who loves his family, someone who loves me and treat me like a queen. Okay, I'm doing 10. Someone who is honest, and someone with like morals and respect. Okay. What is your motto for life? My motto for life is don't worry, be happy. Because, like I said, you can't control everything. Only thing that you can control is yourself and how you respond to certain situations. So, you just gotta say, you know, it's gonna be what it's gonna be, and it is what it's gonna be, and it is what it is. What? I don't know. But you just gotta say, you just gotta know, like, hey, don't worry, be happy, and God will figure, he will sort it out for you. You know what I'm saying? But you gotta also make good decisions. But God got your back, so don't worry, be happy, keep the faith. Purr. It says, do you think of your exes? Sometimes, you know, like, especially one of them, because we literally grew up together and we spent almost 10 years of our life together. So, you know, sometimes I just hope that, you know, he's happy and that, you know, he's living his life and he's happy. And I hope all my exes are happy. It says, do you miss your old friends? I absolutely do miss my old friends, y'all. Like, we would fuss and argue, blah, blah. That's what friends do. But, like, I think I had a great group of friends, and they were a good group of girls. And I hope that they're happy as well. And, you know, yeah. Do you have any regrets? Any regrets that I have? Nope. Because honestly, guys, I feel like, you know, like I said, you can't worry, you gotta be happy. And I feel like, you know, everything that we go through, whether we wanted to go through it or not, like, it's all part of God's plan for us, and it's all a journey, and it's all an experience that, you know, we kind of have to experience, you know, to be molded and to be shaped into the person that we need to be, you know, because God has a purpose for us, and sometimes we are not that person yet that he needs us to be. So we go through these things to learn, to grow, to develop, and then you get to become who you were destined to become. So I don't have any regrets, because I've learned so much from everything that I've been through. And no, you know, I'm not a doctor. That's what I want to be. I want to be an anesthesiologist. I'm not a doctor. I don't live in a penthouse. And, you know, my life didn't go as planned, but it went how it needed to go for me to be who I am today. And so, no, I don't have any regrets. And, yeah, so I will probably be doing, I'm done. I answered all the questions. Probably be doing more of these videos, guys, for you guys in the future. Because most of my videos are like vlog style or stuff like that, but I definitely want to sit in front of the camera and just talk to you guys more often. I just want to say thank you guys for watching this video, and also I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.